Millions of Kenyans head to the polls next Tuesday with two political veterans locked in a fierce battle for the presidency. Memories of violence during previous elections loom large, and the country is grappling with a cost of living crisis, widening inequality, and a crippling drought. Four candidates are vying for the top job, with a tight race between frontrunners Deputy President William Ruto and Raila Odinga, the opposition leader now backed by the ruling party. Campaigning has been dominated by mudslinging, fake news, and the practice of showering prospective voters with freebies, including umbrellas, groceries, and cash. There is speculation Kenya may have its first presidential runoff, and concerns are mounting that if losing candidates challenge the results, the discord could erupt into violence. The leading contenders are familiar faces. Odinga, 77, served as prime minister from 2008 to 2013, and Ruto, 55, became deputy president in 2013. But Ruto, long cast as President Uhuru Kenyatta's successor, saw his ambitions thwarted when his boss shook hands with longtime rival Odinga in 2018. Kenyatta, who has served two terms and cannot run again, has thrown his weight behind Odinga for August 9, giving him access to the ruling Jubilee Party's powerful election machinery. The handshake, however, dealt a blow to Odinga's anti-establishment credentials, prompting suggestions he had effectively battered away his autonomy in exchange for Kenyatta's support. Joining the presidential contest are lawyers David Mwaure and George Wajakoya, the latter an eccentric former spy who wants to legalize marijuana. Kenyans will also choose senators, governors, lawmakers, women representatives, and some 1,500 county officials. Odinga, along his running mate Martha Karua, has vowed to tackle endemic corruption, pointing out that Ruto's running mate Rigathi Gachagua is fighting a graft case. Meanwhile, Ruto, with a rags-to-riches background and a shadowy reputation, has taken aim at the dynasties running Kenya, a reference to the Kenyatta and Odinga families who gave the country its first president and vice president. Ruto has styled himself as hustler-in-chief and champion of the downtrodden in a nation where 3 in 10 people live on less than $1.9 a day, according to the World Bank. Kenyans, already hit by the COVID pandemic, are struggling to afford basic staples as the war in Ukraine pushes up prices. Economic pressures could even compete with tribal allegiances as the key factor driving voter behavior, according to some observers. With neither Ruto nor Odinga belonging to the dominant Kikuyu tribe, which has produced 3 of the country's 4 presidents, the election will open a new chapter in Kenya's history. If Odinga wins, his running mate Martha Karua would become deputy president, the first woman to hold the post.